Okay, class, let's have number 6. And you will notice here that we don't have group 1 or group 2. But we have quadrinomials here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Like also number 7, we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, this is really what we call the factoring by grouping, because we need to group them before we can apply our common binomial. So we have to group this one, but be careful of the sign. They are all positive, so there is no problem here. So we need to group them into two groups. A binomial, first group is a binomial, and the second group is also a binomial. And see if they are arranged or we don't need to arrange them anymore. So if we have this one, do we have a common monomial here? We need to see if we have a common monomial in our binomial here. Do we have a common monomial here? Yes, the B and the B, they are common. What about the 6B and 3A? Do you have a common monomial there? Yes, the 3 is a common monomial. So if we have a common monomial in the first group and a common monomial in the second group here, you can proceed. So here we put this one in a in our parenthesis. We have 2b squared plus ab, and then copy the plus there, and then bracket 6b plus 3a. Now we have two groups, the first group and the second group. In the first group, we need to factor this one using the common monomial. And also in the second group, we see if we can factor them, this group, by common monomial factor also. So here, yes, we have the B here and the B here. So we proceed. B is our common monomial. And we divide 2B squared over B is 2B. And then the plus is here, AB over B is A, copy the plus. We also factor this one by common monomial, and the common factor is, the common factor is 3. So we have 3, and then we have 2B plus A. So the numbers 1 to 5 from here. So here, we can see now the common binomial. First group and second group. So for the common binomial, we have 2b plus a, because they have 2b plus a in both groups. So I'm going to put 2b plus a, and then we need to divide now. This divided by 2b plus a, which is b. This one is B. Plus, get to the plus here. Divide this by 2B plus A. 2B plus A will be equal to 1. Remains is the 3 there. And we have the 3 there. So, can we still factor this one? No. This one? No. So, this is our final answer. Okay, number 7. We have the last one here. So, we need to group this one. So, are we not going to arrange anymore? Yes. We have, because we have already a y here and a y here. And here also we can have our common monomial, which is 2 here. Okay. But be careful, class, because this one is a minus. Here we don't have any problem. We just put this one inside our parenthesis xy plus 3y. Copy the minus, but once we put the minus and we put the parenthesis here, the sign of 2x will change. That one is negative, it will become positive here. So we have 2x. Check. Negative times positive is negative 2x. Okay, fine. Now, it's negative. So what will happen if you have a negative here? It will change. So it is not a negative anymore, class, but a positive. And then we have a 6 here. Careful when you are doing the negative here, because this one will change the sign. Or you may Multiply and see if the signs are correct. Negative times positive 2x, negative 2x, check. Negative times positive is negative, check. Because your mistake, your usually the mistake is of the students, of the learners, they're just going to put a negative here, which is wrong already. Okay. Now here, let us have the common monomial here, which is the y here. We remove the y because that's the common monomial. We divide x, y by y. So we have the x plus 3y divided by y will give us 3. Minus, copy the minus. Common monomial of 2 and 6, we have 2 here. Okay, 2x divided by 2 is x. Copy the plus here. 6 divided by 2 is 3. Right, what's the common here? Common binomial now. We have x plus 3 and x plus 3 in the second group. So we remove x plus 3 and then here. Divide this by x plus 3, cancel, equal to 1, and we have the y. Proceed to minus, write the minus, 2x plus 3, divide x plus 3, cancel x plus 3, is equal to 1, main is the 2 here. So, is this one simplified already? Yes, yes. Therefore, this is our final answer. Okay, thank you very much, class. And see you next time.